Today, we are talking all things wiring for 7 Days to Die Alpha 19. Now, we've got a lot of info to cover and no time to waste, so let's get to it. The electricity system in 7 Days to Die is rather complicated, and one of the most complex aspects of this system is wiring. Trying to work out exactly how to hook up all of your electrical items to your generators or battery banks or solar banks can be rather difficult. So today I'm going to take you through the basics of wiring. I will show you how to wire up items from your power source, the different input and outputs that each of these items has, and give you some basic tips and tricks on how to effectively wire up your electrical system. But the first thing we need to talk about is the fundamental basis of the wiring system in 7 Days to Die, and that is the input-output system. Now, the first rule of the input-output system is this: all electrical items only have one input. Allow me to demonstrate. So in front of me here, I have 10 relays, 10 electric relays, and we have our one generator bank. So we're going to go ahead and wire up our generator to our relay. Now, in order to connect a wire, all you have to do is come to the item that you want to connect. So we'll come to our generator bank here, and if you right click, you will start your wire. And now if we look down at our relay here, we right click again, boom, that connects the wire from the generator bank to the relay. Now, if we left click, that disconnects the wire from the relay. So right click connects, left click disconnects. And for all of my controller users out there, the left trigger connects the wire. So we left trigger on the generator bank and left trigger on the electric relay. The right trigger disconnects. So left trigger connects, right trigger disconnects. So let me demonstrate what I mean when I say all items only have one input. So we connect our generator bank to our first relay, just like that. Now, what would happen if I were to say connect this relay into this relay? Boom. You'll notice that the original connection from the generator bank was severed. That's because all items, even relays, can only accept one input. That means you can only have one wire running to each source. So if we connect our generator bank once again to this same relay, that wire in the middle connecting these two relays is gone. So all electrical items can only have one input. That means one wire running in to the item. So now that we've taken a look at the input system, let's take a look at the output system. So we already know that all electrical items may only have one input. However, all electrical items may have up to 9 outputs. So as you see here, I've got my electric fence post set up here, and I have it hooked up to 9 separate electric fence posts. But if we go ahead and try to connect electric fence post number 10, we come up with that little warning there saying this power component has the maximum number of wired connections. So the maximum number of outputs that each electrical item has is 9. Each electrical item can have up to 9 wired connections at the same time. And I've gone ahead and dotted around here a few examples. So we have our trigger plate here, and I have it hooked up to 9 electric fence posts. We go ahead and try to connect number 10. And once again, we get that error message. And the same holds true with every electrical component. So we have our trip wires here. I have 1x5 trigger plate set up here. And we have our dart trap set up here, all of which have 9 outputs, meaning you can run 9 wires from this dart trap to 9 other electrical items in the game. And that is the basic rule for wiring. One input, but up to 9 outputs. Now, another interesting fact about wiring is you can actually wire through solid blocks. So if I connect my generator bank to this one relay here, and then I connect this relay to this relay, you'll notice that the wire actually goes through the solid pillar. It goes through the solid block. So it is actually possible to wire through solid walls or solid blocks. It is also possible to wire things underground or through ground. So over here, I have a wire relay placed in the ground. So we're going to connect that bad boy up. So you'll see the wire going down under the ground into this relay here. And then we connect this relay to another relay that I have hidden it underground. Boom, just like that. And then let's go ahead and set down a blade trap there. And let's wire up this relay to our blade trap. Now I've got that all good to go and wired up. I'm going to go ahead and fill in these holes. So now our wires are actually underground, all hidden, nice and safe. You'll see they're running from this relay here down into the ground, over to this relay here, and then up to our blade trap. So now if we go up and we turn on our generator bank here, there we go. And you'll notice the blade trap is spinning, so the electricity is still flowing. So it is possible to run wires through walls or solid blocks, as well as underground. Now, one more thing I wanted to point out here. You have to be very, very careful when you are disconnecting wires. So as we see here, I've got my generator bank hooked up to this center relay, and then I have this relay hooked up to the relays to the sides here. So we're going from the generator bank to the relay, and from the relay to the other two relays. Now let's say I want to remove this wire here between these two relays. In order to do that, what we would have to do is hover over this relay here, and then click the disconnect button. That will remove that wire. Now let's say you accidentally are hovering over this relay when you hit that disconnect button. Boom, you'll notice that it disconnected the wire from the generator. So that teaches us that the wire that gets snipped, or the wire that gets disconnected, is the input wire. So this wire here going from the generator into this relay is the one that will be cut. So if you're looking to disconnect a specific wire, you always wanna make sure follow that wire to its endpoint. Like let's say we wanna disconnect this wire here, we follow it to its endpoint here, and then we disconnect from the component here, because you are disconnecting the input wire, not the output wire. Very, very important thing to keep in mind when you are wiring up your system, because it is very easy to accidentally disconnect the wrong wire. Also, let's say that you are wiring up your system and you accidentally start a wire that you really don't need. So if I connect this here, so we've got our wire in our hand, and we're like, oh darn it, I didn't want to connect this wire here. In this instance, all you have to do is hit that disconnect button and you will disconnect from that relay. So if you want to disconnect an existing wire, follow it to its endpoint and disconnect it from the object at its endpoint. So for instance, once again, if we're disconnecting this wire right here, we want to come to where the power flow stops and disconnect it there. Boom. To disconnect a wire that has not been completed yet, all you have to do is simply hit the disconnect button. You don't even have to be hovered over the item. So I could be pointing over here. You can see the wire on the ground there. And I'm like, nope, I don't want that wire. Just simply hit the disconnect and that'll get rid of that wire right there. The electricity system in 7 Days to Die is rather complicated and can be extremely confusing, especially trying to figure out how to wire up all of your components. But in order to understand the wiring system, you really only need to understand two basic principles. That is the amount of inputs and the amount of outputs that each item has available. All electrical equipment has only one input available, meaning you can only have one wire moving in to your object. However, each electrical item has a maximum of 9 outputs available, meaning you can have up to 9 wires coming out from your object. Understanding these two basic rules will make wiring up your electrical system a whole lot easier. Also, keep in mind that it is possible to wire through solid blocks as well as underground. And you want to be very, very careful when disconnecting a wire. You want to make sure that you are disconnecting the right one. Disconnecting a wire will disconnect the input wire for that block. As we demonstrated with our relays, whatever item you have selected or you hover over with your cursor, when you hit that disconnect button, the input wire for that object is what will be disconnected. Now, this was just a basic understanding of the wiring system. I do have a video covering advanced wiring techniques coming in the near future, but I feel it is important that you get the basics down before you try to tackle something really really complicated. But for those of you who do have the basics down, I do have an advanced wiring tutorial coming in the not too distant future. Now I hope you folks have found this video helpful and or enjoyable. If you did and you'd like to see more, I've created a very special playlist of electricity tutorials that you can access by clicking the box in the top right corner of the screen. But for now, this is Savin saying thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me in Savin's World. And remember, the average gamer is always king of the hill on the bell curve.